alongside, hopefully, my longtime partner, Al Snow. I am the coach, and we've got quite a ride for you here this week on Heat.
Well, we've had quite a ride, that's for sure, this week.
Only contest is scheduled for one ball. Introducing first, weighing 150 pounds, Spike Dudley.
Now, before we even get started, I have to publicly apologize to you, costing you your job and mine on Raw this past Monday night. I'm sorry.
I'll be honest, I'm disappointed, but, Coach, we're still buds.
We are. There'll be another day. There'll be another time. But Al, we have a job to do. We are professionals, and that's what we have to do.
You know, and that's what brought us to the dance. To the ring, our professionalism.
Jackie Gina from Las Vegas, Nevada, weighing 238 pounds, Rico.
Should be a great opening contest here on Heat. Rico going one-on-one with Spike Dudley. And if there is anything that could pick our spirits up, certainly it would be Jackie Gina, Al. Oh, wait, I'm sorry. She's one of your kids.
That's right, so 6 feet, you pervert. Stay away.
I will tell you this, Al, before we get away from what happened last Monday night, the fact that JR did beat me, I will admit that.
Yeah.
But this thing between me and JR, Stone Cold Steve Austin, and yourself, it is not over. It's far from being over.
Far from being over. I still don't know what you were thinking of in a country whipping match.
Well, if you notice, I had him almost the entire time.
I know.
I admit, I got a little cocky, a little overbearing. I wanted to impress you, maybe a little bit too much.
Well, and our boss, Eric Bischoff, I mean, he panicked. Let's face it. He distracted you because he panicked.
Well, but we don't want to put any of the blame on Eric Bischoff, faithful leader, who is still going to lead us to the promised land.
He's such a good man.
Yes, he is.
So, such high quality, such fine timber. You know what I mean?
Well, this crowd letting their feelings be. Yes,
a saint among men.
You are picking up my spirits. I really thought I was going to have a difficult time doing the show this week. I really did. But I'm starting to feel better about myself.
You shouldn't feel bad.
Well,
you were up against some insurmountable odds. JR in there with the mad power driven Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Oh, wait a second.
Oh.
Rico starting to enjoy that a little bit too much.
Oh, we've had discussions about Rico before. I wonder if he'd like a country whipping match.
Now
he's been such a bad boy.
We've got quite a show for everybody a little bit later on. Steven Richards, Mr. Stevie Knight Heat, will go one-on-one against the never-boring Lance Storm.
Oh, Mr. Personality, Captain Charisma, the dancer.
Tommy Dreamer will be here in action. Also, my main man, Rodney Mack with Theodore Long in the house here tonight. Oh. What a clothesline by Spike.
Spike Dudley turning up a notch. Looks like he recovered nicely from the concussion that Rob Conway and La Resistance gave him a couple weeks ago.
Nice hip toss, and now, as I like to say, the biggest four-year-old in the business, Spike Dudley, just hammering away on Rico.
He looks like he's went through puberty. I don't think he's anything close to being
Well, I'm just saying he acts like one. I'm not saying he actually
That's
is
That's only
one.
When he's drunk.
Which is fairly often.
It's about 23 and a half hours a day.
Well, now Spike off the ropes, and Rico going for the clothesline. Spike a little bit too quick. Oh. How about a little
No.
Well, a modified Dudley dog, if you will.
It's called a headlock takeover, Coach, for those of us that have been in the biz.
Also, a little bit later on, we're going to take everybody back in that huge blockbuster announcement, Al, that Triple H, the game, had this past Monday night concerning Goldberg.
Yeah, Coach, I think he's got about, I don't know, about 100,000 reasons to worry now.
If I'm Goldberg, I'm looking over my shoulder everywhere that I go. And now,
Spike
again.
Spike going.
Oh,
right in the turnbuckle.
Rico able to counter. Thought maybe Spike was going to nail Rico and land this victory. What a huge win this would be for either man.
On the top rope.
And we say it seems like we say week after week, Al, that Rico can turn his personality in the ring on and off.
And I've pointed out, I think that he does a lot of this to set his opponents off, to throw off their strategy.
Well, speaking of setting us off, Jackie Gaeta, as always, looking tremendous at ringside.
Jackie came up to me backstage.
Right.
And let me know that they might be debuting, she and Rico might be debuting their fall line.
Really?
Yeah, I have no idea what their fall line could be.
Hopefully when it comes to Jackie Gate, it's very revealing. And hopefully Rico is covering everything up. And now going into the corner, nobody home. Spike is able to get out of the way.
Covering everything up.
You know, also, Al, I failed the mid-rope slam by Rico.
Pushed him up for a backdrop, dropped him over his shoulder into a power slam.
And here's a cover, but way too close to the rope. Spike easily grabs that lower rope. Al, also, a little bit later on right here on Heat, we're going to take everybody back to that incredible ladder match between RVD and Christian with the Intercontinental title on the line last Monday night. Here's another cover by Rico. Oh, Spike is able to kick out.
That was practically a career ender for both men.
Both men certainly putting their careers on the line, putting their livelihoods on the line, putting their bodies on the line, and what a night it turned out to be.
And what about Big Papa Pump, Freakzilla, putting his hands on Stacy?
We will never agree with that. We said that Monday night.
You're
I will say that
right.
Again tonight. But Big Papa Pump, whatever's come out of Scott Steiner, I don't know if I like it. Now Jackie Gator showing real concern here at ringside. Now a shot to the back of Spike Dudley.
Up and over. Oh, he thought he threw him to the floor.
You know, it seems to me, oh, what a shot to the kisser. Rico showing that martial arts background.
Why can't you just stay down?
Spike fighting back. Oh, he's biting his head.
Now gnawing on the head of Rico.
There you go.
Did I just say that? Now,
the gerbil squirter. The gerbil squirter by Spike. That'll leave a brown mark on your tights.
Jackie continues to implore her man on, and Spike is feeling very good about himself. But if I'm Spike, I want to finish this right now.
Oh.
And here's a cover by Spike. Hook in the leg. 1-2-0. Oh, and Rico is able to get that left shoulder up.
Not the size of the man in the fight, but the size of the man in the fight. I don't know what I just said.
What did you just say?
I have no idea.
Here's a cover by Spike. And again.
You know, I'm still a little upset at you, and my mind's preoccupied on what happened last Monday night.
Well, I thought that you were trying to entertain me, and you are.
I am.
You are doing it.
But, you know, he's getting rolled up.
A nice roll up by Spike. Oh, Rico, again, almost taken to the limit. And this Spike Dudley's doing everything that he can.
What's good for the goose is good for the goose. I think.
Battering ram into the midsection of Rico. And now Jackie Gata up on the ring apron.
Up where she does not belong. She could prove to be a liability if she's not careful.
Go ahead, plant one on her, Spike. Oh, and Rico, as Spike seemingly had eyes in the back of his head.
Rolling reverse.
This one's over.
Rico got a handful of tights. Probably not the first time for him. And he pulls it off.
Here is your winner, Rico.
Rico with a handful of tights.
That's right.
Pulls off the win over Spike Dudley. It really seemed like for the last couple of minutes that Spike was going to be able to get the job done. But Jackie Gata tonight doing her job.